Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be discussing some of the important counter circuits that are widely used in digital designs. Let's start with an overview. A counter is a logic circuit that keeps track of the number of occurrences of a particular event. It stores this count in memory elements, typically flip-flops, and uses a clock signal as a reference for counting. Counters have several key applications. As digital timers, they are used to measure time in digital circuits. Counter circuits are also used as frequency dividers to help reduce the frequency of signals. As finite state machines, these circuits track states in sequential logic systems. These applications show how versatile and crucial counters are in digital electronics. Counters can be classified based on two primary criteria, based on the direction and based on clocking method. Based on direction, the up counter increments the count, the down counter decrements the count, and the bidirectional counter, which is also known as up-down counter, can do both incrementing and decrementing the count. Counters can be categorized in two categories based on how the clock signal propagates through the circuit: asynchronous counters and synchronous counters. In asynchronous counters, only the first flip-flop gets the main clock and the others are clocked at later times. While in synchronous counters, all flip-flops are clocked at the same time. Let's talk about the asynchronous counters in detail. These counters are also known as ripple counters. In these counters, only the first flip-flop is directly clocked by the main clock signal. The subsequent flip-flops are clocked sequentially, with each flip-flop's clock input driven by the output of the previous flip-flop. This counter design makes the state changes to ripple through the chain of flip-flops. Thus, the propagation delay from the input to output of the counter accumulates as the number of flip-flops increases. This makes these counters slower in operation. Despite this limitation, asynchronous counters have a simple design with minimal hardware, making them suitable for low-frequency applications. Here is a block diagram of a 3-bit ripple counter. The flip-flops are labeled as FF0, FF1, and FF2, corresponding to the least significant bit to most significant bit. Each flip-flop has a clock input, an input D, output Q, and Qn. Qn is Q-bar. As discussed earlier, in this counter, FF0 is directly connected to the main clock. However, FF1 and FF2 are clocked sequentially by the output of the preceding flip-flop. FF1's clock input is connected to FF0 Qn, and FF2 clock input is connected to FF1 Qn. The output of the three flip-flops are Q0, Q1, and Q2, representing the counter's 3-bit binary output. Now, let's see how the count sequence is generated during the operation. At start, when the active low asynchronous reset is low, all flip-flops are initially reset to zero, making Q0, Q1, Q2 all zeros. At the first clock pulse, FF0 toggles its state from 0 to 1, and the output becomes 001. In second clock pulse, FF0 toggles from 1 to 0, and the falling edge of FF0Q, that is the rising edge of FF0Qn, triggers FF1, toggling its state from 0 to 1, and the output is 010. On third clock pulse, FF0 toggles again. FF1 remains same because FF0Qn has a falling edge, and thus the output is 011. On the fourth clock pulse, FF0 toggles from 1 to 0. The falling edge of FF0Q or rising edge of FF0Qn toggles FF1 from 1 to 0. The falling edge of FF1Q triggers FF2, toggling its state from 0 to 1, and the output is 100. This process repeats for subsequent clock pulses, generating a 3-bit binary sequence from 000 to 111. Here is the Verilog code for asynchronous counter. Now let's look at synchronous counters, also known as parallel counters. In synchronous counters, all flip-flops share a common clock and are clocked simultaneously. This design has a significant advantage over asynchronous counters. Since all flip-flops operate in parallel, there is no cumulative delay, making synchronous counters ideal for high-speed applications. However, the design is slightly more complex compared to asynchronous counters. This complexity is justified in application where the speed is critical. This is how a 3-bit synchronous binary up counter is structured. The 3D flip-flops are labeled as FF0, FF1, and FF2, corresponding to the least significant bit to most significant bit. A single clock signal drives all the flip-flops in parallel. Additional combinational logic gates are required to control the toggling behavior of each flip-flop based on the counter state. The output of the flip-flops is labeled as Q0, Q1, and Q2, representing the 3-bit binary counter output. For FF0, D input is connected to FF0QN, so it toggles every clock pulse. For FF1, D input is controlled by the XOR of FF0Q and FF1Q. For FF2, the D input is controlled by a logic that combines FF0Q and FF1Q in AND gate and XORs it with FF2Q. At initial stage, when the active low asynchronous reset is low, all flip-flops are initially reset to 0 and the output is 0, 0, 0. At the first clock pulse, FF0 toggles from 0 to 1. FF1 and FF2 remain unchanged and the output is 0, 0, 1. At the second clock pulse, FF0 toggles from 1 to 0. FF1 toggles because XOR of FF0Q and FF1Q is 1 at the rising edge of the clock. FF2 remains unchanged and the output is 0, 1, 0. At the third clock pulse, FF0 toggles again from 0 to 1. FF1 remains same because XOR of FF0Q and FF1Q stays 1 and the output is 1. FF2 remains unchanged and the output of the counter is 0, 1, 1. In the fourth clock pulse, FF0 toggles from 1 to 0. For FF1, the XOR of FF0Q and FF1Q is 0, so FF1 toggles from 1 to 0. FF2 toggles because FF0Q and FF1Q both are 1 and the output of the AND gate is 1. When this 1 is XORed with FF2Q, that is 0, the value at input D is 1. Hence, FF2Q is 1 and the output is 1, 0, 0. The counter continues to increment the binary count from 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1 and then wraps back to 0, 0, 0. This is the Verilog code for a 3-bit synchronous counter. Another example of synchronous counter is the ring counter. A synchronous ring counter is a type of counter where a single one propagates through the sequence of flip-flop like a ring structure. These counters are commonly used in state machines due to their simplicity and reliability tracking specific state. In these counters, the count sequence length is equal to the number of flip-flops in the ring. An important condition for using a ring counter is to set an initial one in one of the flip-flops during initialization. Here is the block diagram of a 3-bit synchronous ring counter. There are 3D flip-flops labeled as FF0, FF1, and FF2 arranged in sequence to form a ring. Each flip-flop has a clock input, a data input D, and output Q. A single clock signal drives all the flip-flops. The output of each flip-flop is connected to the input of the next flip-flop in the ring. The output of the last flip-flop, FF2, is fed back to the input of the first flip-flop, forming a closed loop. This counter requires an initial state where one flip-flop output is set as 1 and all others are 0. This is done using reset signal. The counter operates by shifting 1 around the flip-flops with each clock pulse. At initial state, only the output of FF0 is high and the output of FF1 and FF2 are low. At first clock pulse, the output of FF0 is fed to FF1. So now FF1 stores 1. The output is 0, 1, 0. In second clock pulse, the output Q1 is fed to FF2 and now the output state is 1, 0, 0. In third clock pulse, the output FFF2 is fed back to FF0 and now FF0 stores 1 and the sequence is again 0, 0, 1. The counter continues cycling through the sequence 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 100 repeatedly with each clock pulse. The sequence length is equal to number of flip-flops. For a 3-bit ring counter, the sequence length is 3. This is the Verilog code for the ring counter. This wraps up the discussion on some of the key counter circuits. I hope this helped you to gain a clear understanding of their functionality and design. If you have any questions, please post in comments.